Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build EVO clocks that are one block wide and can be tiled next to each other until infinity. I will also show you how they can be deactivated and how you can get an output of them, out of them. So now just what are the space requirements for those clocks? As you can see, it's actually not one tileable design, but it are two designs that can be tiled next to each other, so you have to alternate between them. And the size of it is 8 blocks long, 4 blocks high, and as I already mentioned, 1 block wide. Plus, if you want to deactivate it, an additional 2 blocks in the length, and if you want to take an output, which you of course you want at some point, you will also need 1 block more to this side here. Okay, so now that's the space, what are the resources you need? Basically each of those EVO clocks has 6 normal blocks, then 2 redstone wire, 1 redstone block, 2 comparators, 2 sticky pistons, and finally 2 hoppers. And that's it. Additional, if you want to deactivate it, you will need 1 redstone repeater and 1 piece of redstone extra, and if you want to take an output, the easiest way is using a torch like this. Or of course, if you need the inverted signal, you can also use a repeater at this point here. But anyway, so that's what you will be needing in resources and space. So now let's start with the actual building. So let's start with the first vertical EVO clock here. For this, the easiest way is starting with the two hoppers. Place them facing into each other like this. Then put a block on the side of it, like this, and complete it to a little cross shape, like this, both sides. Then put a comparator in the middle of this cross shape, redstone on top of the side of this, then two sticky pistons facing each other here, like this. And finally a redstone block between them. So that's pretty much a really standard EVO clock in a vertical design, one wide design. Now you can place some items in here, and as you can see, the clock starts running. And well, now let's place the next clock right besides this one. For this, let's start again with the hoppers. This time place them again at the same height as the hoppers of the first clock. Then let's place 3 blocks here, like earlier in the cross shape, but now don't place the fourth one on top of it, but below, like this. The same on this side here, and this time don't place the redstone on top of this block here, but on top of the block down here. So again the comparators, and this time the sticky pistons are below like this, with the redstone block besides in between them. And this is the second EVO clock here. So just to show it how it's working. So now if you want to get an output from those clocks here, you can actually place torches on top of on the side of these blocks here. And as you can see, every full cycle you get a short pulse out of this clock this torch here. If you want to deactivate it, all you have to do is run a, come on, where is the a repeater into this block here, and if you then power it, the clock gets deactivated, as you can see here. And now if you need more than two clocks, you just have to copy this pattern. So the next on this side would be with the cross shape again, then we would have a cross shape down here again, and so on and so on. And this way you can have as many of those EFO clocks besides each other as you want. Okay. So that was how you can build one white tile label EFO clocks. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya.